All right, so I am gonna stream this. So this is right here. This is gonna be my first time actually showing this on stream. The whole editing process for how I, for personally how I mod this stuff. So this is the song I just thought about last night at like 2 a.m. I thought I was like, because I was trying to do the Joji's Glimpse of Us, but then I realized the timing was a little bit off. I mean, well, the timing was off was first, very slow. It's at 57, and I could double time it to 114, but even when I did that and I tested it in the game, didn't work out as well as I thought it would. So I was like, I'll just scrap that whole thing, put something new, and this is what I'm gonna try to go with. So the song is Forever by Chris Brown. And I know this is gonna be like this is gonna be muted after this post. I know this will happen. So just but wait, let me just yeah, no, it's just gonna happen. So all right, here we go. So we're right now I'm trying to structure the game, structure the song essentially. If I could show the thing, yeah, go. So right here I have two things up right now, which is the instrumental and acapella. I found this on YouTube. And I downloaded it, took it onto here. So now that I have them, it took me like maybe like a minute to time it so that the acapella and the instrumental, when you press play, it plays like a normal song. Okay, so how I have it structured, this is good. This is kind of loud, so sorry about that. But I need it to be. Well, actually, on stream, I don't have to make it this loud. Oh, I wonder. I forgot what number I just had it on, but I think I had it like up to here. But I am structuring the whole game starting when you press play. It's gonna be like a normal structure. There's gonna be like it's gonna be a normal verse, normal build up. Normal chorus, and then a second chorus. Most of the game has it just like that, so I'm essentially gonna do the same exact way. But how I've done it in previous songs, like an older song that I had, that you've seen in my streams and you've seen it in my edits, you could see this right here. So this is my Jungle Fury edit. This is the like I was the one that created that song, and in there, I structured it to have this down green down here is one drop, a build, and then it keeps building, and then another drop, and then it goes back to the drop again. That's how I structured Jungle Fury. For what I've done now is that, oh, actually, Mimi, let me just, yeah, don't save, reload the, like, I've made a lot of songs. You'll see a lot in here. You see a lot of the ones that I have on here. Like all I ASMR, Bangarang. I now have Barbie Girl, which I will play that for the first time then. I have Cake by the Ocean, Cinema, Do It, Don't You Worry Child. I just recently put in Cashmere again. I needed my Cashmere, got Edge, and then I got Forever. I made a lot of songs ever since this came out. But now this is the newest one. Let's see how well this will work. I want to see how many times this is going to take me because previously, before. It would take me about three or four like retries in order to get it right for that, like to get it to sound decent in the game. But then I'd all have to change the audio, change like the volumes, and maybe change a little bit on transitioning. But what's nice about this song though is that this has its own kind of transition. I have it finished right here. Like this is the deck infuser. So how it's gonna end and go back to the beginning is just like this. So if you know the song. And then it'll go right back to the beginning. That's how I want it. That's kind of how I want to take it. People have put in like a drum fill to go transition back to the beginning. But for me, since the song is just, it's going to solo its own thing, I'm going to work with it just like that. So all we have to do is try to get the time hit right on beat as if. Any other song that I was going to play, they would have to play at the same time. Right now, I'm just trying to structure it. So this is gonna be the first time I'm gonna actually stream and record something at the same time, because in order for me to actually make this into stems, is that right here the instrumental, it has the drums, it has the bass, and it has the synth all into one thing right here. The second one's the acapellas, which is already done, so I don't have to do anything to that. The only thing I'm working on now is that drum and then bass and synths stem. I could make it just it's a drum and then the instrumental stems, or I could do bass and synth. Really just depends on how I hear it, and if it sound if the bass is really like if the AI that I use and it picks it up really well, then I'm gonna make it into a bass sound. But if it can't pick up that well, and I can't manipulate it as well as you can to make it sound like an actual bass hitting the in the song, then I'll most likely put them together, put it as a three disc song, where it has a drum, instrumental, and then the lyric. And I won't have a chance to separate them. There has been some songs where you can separate them and they sound good, or where you don't need to separate them and they already sound good together as it is. So, all right, let's go through the process. So we are 5 minutes in. I've kind of made my explanation. We now put it saved it as the song. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna save it as an MP3 and song. Now it's saved into my hard drive as the song itself. So I already pulled up the website that people have used. For me, like right here, this is the part where, let me make sure it is 1 minute and 3 seconds. So at the bottom here, it shows how long the song is. And I'm assuming that this song isn't, it's gotta be like 115 BPM for it to be just a little bit longer than a minute. So let me go find that song that I just put up. You'll see all my audio files. Every single one of these things is either the sound itself or for a disc in the deck. Let me just go to the F, forever edit song. It'll make it do its magic. So like I said, this is gonna be my first time recording something and streaming. So I don't know how the audio, I don't know how it's gonna change, but I'm gonna like stay quiet and not make any noise so it can record the actual like desktop sounds. So yeah, this is the part where I'm like, I'm so into it, but you never see it behind the scenes. So this is the first time I'm streaming it and it's all behind the scenes. Yeah. It's kind of a little bit of a wait. And what's kind of sucks sometimes is that, on other parts where I while it's loading, on other parts, since this is literally just one shot, this is really easy. There has been other songs like the Jungle Fury song. I had to put four different parts into it, and I had to mesh it together so that when it goes to the next part that's like cut and like chopped up, it needs to blend in well. And usually I would fade it in, or maybe I would like it would be just a straight cut into it. It really kind of depends on how I see it. But for this one, it's just one go. That's it. That's all you need. And then it goes right back to the beginning. That's it. All right, here we go. So this is what I'll end up doing. So over here, you'll see the, I mean, my thing is blocking it, but you'll see vocal, drums, bass, electric, acoustic guitar, piano, and synthesizer. What I'll be using for this specific song is just gonna be drums, and then I will test the bass. But what it already gives me is what's the drums, and since this is the instrumental version, it'll be all the rest of the instruments that's not the drum. So what you'll hear is this, which is pretty good, and then here's the without the drum, which is just instrumental, no lyrics either. You'll hear a little bit of like drums in there, like I hear the little like what is that called? It's like a yeah, it's like. Yeah, it reminds me of a coconut. But pretty good. But in this right here, I could hear that bass being played out in here. So after I finish doing the drum stem, I'm gonna get over. So this is my friend. I'm gonna click record. I wanna see what happens, so. Okay, so what's convenient about that is that it's the same the whole way. What I did just forget, I forgot to mute myself, so now I gotta hear this. Let me hear this thing. Let me see if it sounds okay. Hold up. So. Okay. So it seems like it didn't pick up anything else, which is nice. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to mute myself here again, and then it'll just be playing the instruments. And yeah, let me do that. Yeah. Okay, so now that I have those two recorded, I do want to let you know that this thing, the preview, is honestly all you needed because it only does a minute, even though this thing is like a minute and 3 seconds. Some songs are super slow and they need about like a minute and like 10 seconds. But sometimes I would have to make another edit to cut into it from here and kind of mess around with that. Some I don't, and I could just fill it in based off what the raw audio is. For this one, I mean, all it is just a few notes and a drum hit. The lyrics is the lyrics, so that's going to stay as it is. But it seems like everything else seems pretty good. So now, though, I just made two stems, the drums and the... Oh, wait. Before I go there, let me hear the bass. So I'm going to create a preview of that bass, and then I'm going to hear what that sounds like. So if it sounds good, I will make a bass like disc. If it doesn't sound good, I'll just keep it as that instrumental disc that you just heard. So once it goes through, we should try it out. Ow. Oh, wow. So usually my indicator is like, if it's super like this much, then I'm like, okay, then it's not going to be that loud. This one's actually pretty big, so I expect this to be pretty good. Let me just hear it. Oh, we got it. Not bad. Okay. So what I'm, even though it sounds very like very low in volume, it's not muffled, which that was my only problem, is that sometimes when the AI does it, it gets it really muffled to where I'm like, okay, it doesn't even sound like a bass anymore. This one sounds like a bass. So, and they actually captured it very well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to record the bass part, and then I'm probably going to take the audio from this one and then get the other deck, the other disc for that one. So, and what I'm going to have to do, I'm going to make this a lot louder in the actual editing, in the editing software, and then do the same thing for the other one, so that when they play together, you'll hear the bass for sure, and you'll get the accompaniment of the synth, which will always be there. But a lot of times when you put it in the game with the bass, even though it sounds good when they play all together with instrumentals of the drum and the synth, when you take that bass and put it to another mix, into another song, you don't hear it as well. Because it's so masked by everything else. Because I feel that when Fuser, when they make that bass sound, they amplify it a lot so that you could really hear it. So I feel that that's what I might have to do on this one as well. So let me mute myself and then I'll record this one. Okay. Now that I got that one, I'm also gonna get the, I'm gonna do this as well. So remember that instrumental recording? I'm gonna take that one and then remove the bass of it, and that should be just everything else. Hopefully this might work, because I don't want to make another recording and just add another file to my hard drive. So I'll just take the one that I have and let's work with this one. So see, like, literally the hardest part about modding this game is to time it with everything else in the actual game itself. If you can't time it, everything that you did is, it's there, it's just, it's not like on beat. And that's like the hardest part, is you trying to put it in and put it in and put it again and put it again, and to the point where I'm like, okay, now that the drums are at the same beat, everything else should be the same. And I'll show you how I do that one as well. So let me just hear this, see how this sounds. Just like how it would sound, that's good. All right, let's record one more time and hopefully we can actually work on it. So here we go. Okay, so what I might have to do, I'm gonna have to like copy and paste it, but pretty much got it. All right, so we're gonna go to a folders, video folder. All right, now, got how many I made? That, I think it's that. You're gonna see me as the clip because I literally just recorded my stream. This is the part where I'm trying to trim it down just to get that timing in. From here on out, it doesn't really matter because this little portion down here is literally just trying to test it. Oh my God, it's lagging as fuck. Oh fuck. All right. Is it working? Okay. Yeah. This stream might lag a little bit because I just realized the CPU is trying to run my software and the stream itself. So this is going to be interesting. So like what I was saying, this part down here, I zoomed it in really big. This is one beat right here. this little gap in space, it really depends on how I started. Cause I really don't know when the actual beat hits, I don't know how much little space I need. But it'll be trial and error until I get it. But yeah, we're gonna try to get this. All right, so this is the part we're gonna test out. Okay, so this is just a few couple more beats. So I'm just gonna take this one right here, just plop it in just like that. Usually, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna test it with it. So actually I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna take this down here, put it right up on top. Once I can find exactly when it hits together, usually I use this line, which, oh my God, that's actually perfect. So what I'm gonna do right here is I'm gonna take it down here, zoom it in, take it again. What I'm gonna do is I'm literally gonna do this. So I'm just gonna, since they're at the same, I just drag it down. At least move you. No. Drag you down. There you go. All right. So. Yeah. So I literally gave myself an extra couple beats. And what I do from there is I do it again. Same idea. That's pretty good itself. We'll take this, drop it down as well. And it looks like that it dropped it here, so that's where it's gonna stop. The drums will stop right here, so it'll sound just like this. Oh, ew, what the fuck? let me do this. Since I just realized I hit the wrong one, so take this out. Okay. So this is what I was saying. So this is what I would chop off. That was my bad. Okay. I can actually, no. I'd have to do it this way. Then I'll take these two. Yeah, here. That's it. Yeah. If I could hear it based off this, this is... Yeah, just like that. All right, so we're good there. We got the drum set. We have it figured out. All we got to do now is... What we can do, we could make dead space right here. This is going to be just blank. Oops, shit. Get this down here. All right. So, like I said, right here is going to be blank space. So it's going to be muted. But it does give the foundation of how long this thing should be. Because for other discs and whatnot, if I'm making the drum as the foundation line, everything that's going to be put on top of it is going to have to go in line with this drum. So that's why I was saying that all I need to do when I put it in the game, right now I just need to test the drum section. And if I could time the drum section perfectly, then everything else that I put on top of that, on top of this drum section, is going to be just in line with everything else, and then the whole the modded song is complete at that point. So the two parts that I need are the bass and the instruments, and that's it. That is all you need. And like I said, it's gonna freeze. Okay, CPU. Okay, there you go. Yeah, you are running at 7 frames a second for like, oh god. All right. The CPU was going off for a bit there. All right, so one part is drums, one part is bass, and that's it. That's it. I'm actually watching my CPU trying to run this all at the same time. It is not used to this. There you go. Okay. So usually I kind of get an estimate there. And then I'll throw it all in at once. And I would just hear it. I mean, I would do one by one, actually. Just like, let's do this. And then make sure that I could test it with the drums. I could test it with the audio of the actual song. Thing is, they're not all in timed. We're going to make it as best we can. But we're just trying to get the right area. I think I could just use the drum portion, since this is where it's all basing off of. So here we go. You see me and me up there bobbing our heads to this. Like, this is the part where I really enjoy. Like, I really like to try to find the timing. And then obviously everyone loves to play it, but making it behind the scenes is it's very calming. It's just something that I can just do. I might just a little bit move it, just a little. I think it's best this way, I think. Feel that it's off a little bit. Hold up. I'm gonna test it off of the actual audio and just kind of hear it out. I do want to test out the drums to work with the audio, so give me 1 second. So just so I have everything in line as I do it. It's just off. Damn it. All right, let me do this. I'm gonna work you just like this and move you in. So with that there, I'm gonna time the synth with this synth, just so they can be together. I'm gonna raise this up like crazy. So we're gonna put this to maybe about like 200. I kind of want to hear it with the bass, so give me 1 second. I kind of want to hear it all together here. Okay, who's ahead? Wait. Okay, the drum is a little bit ahead, so I'm gonna have to move the bass in just a little bit. So you're moving in just a little bit, and now we'll see. Nope, way too early. Just like this, maybe? Nope. It's like a beat and a half. The synth does not help right now. I need it. Okay. Let me work at the bass line first, I guess. Okay, that's actually not bad. So if I did this just a little bit, what would happen if I did this at that part of the song? Nope. I feel I'm just a little bit off, like just so slightly. So the bass sounds good on its own, so that's great, that's good. Now we gotta time the synth, and that should be good from there. All we have to do after that is just to get this little, you see that little bottom portion? We just need to get that continued and then looped, and we should be good. That's going to be my reference point. So how does that sound in the actual thing? I'm going to mute all of you, and then we're going to just hear it. I want to hear that synth. It's literally at the halfway point. Okay. So we're going to try to get that little timing of the synth that. It's just a little off. Okay, wherever that is, Just got to get that in there, so. It's a little early, so now we're going to have to move it just a little bit. We're going to play it again. It's a little late now. Jeez. Okay. The bass is what's killing me right now. So this is the part where I'm just like, okay, cool. This is where I'm trying to figure this out. It sounds weird to me, but maybe it's not. I don't know. But I still want to get it right. I still want to get it perfect. So let me just hear it again. Now I hear the bass is off for a second. Wait, wait. Yeah, it's a little off. I hear it. I hear the little ticking thing from the wait, I hear it. Maybe that should be my timing. It sounds a little off and I hear it. That's annoying. I don't know where that dip is. Hey, is that a part? Like, where does that hit? So we're trying to, I hear the, I'm trying to see where that hits in regards to the bass and the drum. It hits all together. All right, perfect. So that's my new reference point again. I'm just trying to find a point where I'm like, okay, where do they all hit at the same time? Fuck, where was it? I think that's it. Think if I can move it more, that would be nice. But I cannot, so I'm gonna have to do this. the closest I could get. But I hear the little, the coconuts or whatever that is, I hear that separating. How do I time that? What the fuck? How do I get that? All right, that's, maybe I can move it in just a little, even more, but I don't know how much that's going on. I feel that it is good. Now we just gotta continue it. So how the heck does this song go again? From here. You can shut this up. I can shut you all up over there. Now how does this go? Okay, all right. Okay, we could. Then we can keep this up. Just like that. So we just need the little, we just need this part. Which I could just copy and paste. So I can grab this, throw this in here. Where is that? This part right here. I'm grabbing you. Okay, I'm grabbing this and I'm taking it in here. Right here. That's where I'm throwing it. I'll paste it right here. I just have to time it with everything else. Based on what I got. Taking this. Shutting this up and placing it down. Now this could go, I guess, down. There we go. So what I would do, I would mute it there, and then I would take that same section that I got from here. So, oh wait, no, it would have to be this section. Right there. So this. This. Okay, just like that. Right here. Paste. So what we're doing now is we're gonna time everything based off of that. I think I got it. I'll maybe do something like this and I would like play it together, so. Little point right here is right there, so I think that would be good. All right, so usually what I would do for that is I would fade out this, fade in this. That's how I would blend them together in a way. actually, I would give it a little bit more leeway. Yeah, no, it'll be right here is where that note hit right there. So this will be the note. That. If I could hear what this did, let me hear what this did. Okay, it didn't even hit this note right here. So this should be it right here. So now, oh yeah, now we're at this point. I think we got it. I think we got the song. So I'm just gonna, well, actually, yeah. We're gonna put it with the lyrics. Hold up. We're gonna try it with the lyrics here. So, all right, we'll see. I'm curious to see how this sounds. Feels like we're on another level. Feels like heck no. That is a little off. All right, we're gonna move it in just a little bit. Because there's one beat that I saw right here. This needs to be together. This hit and that hit needs to be together right there. Once we can do that, we should be able to get the red disc part in there. So let's see. We can be too red. Fuck that. We can be too. I think that's it. Feels like our love's intertwined. We can be too. Now it's a little bit fuck. So we're gonna have to move just a little bit. Oh my god, if it could let me. Feels like we're on another. Oh, yeah. It's like I. It's like I'm waiting my whole life. Oh, it's one night. One night. Okay, so it is gonna be a little loud, but it's based. It's for how I like put it into the game. That drum needs to be a lot louder than 100. So excuse me while I just throw all this in here. This is gonna be about. Has to be about 200. The bass has to be really loud. 250 is good. 200 there. The lyrics is already loud enough. So I think once you mesh it together. Alright. So. Okay, I think this is what we're gonna do. So we're gonna test this out. So like I said, what I do is when I put in my songs in, I mute everything else, but I make an official drum track and I test the drums based off how the drums are in the game. So I'm saving as an OGG file from what's said in the video as the drums. Now I need to open the mod itself. So this is what I think everyone sees when they make the mod as they're making it. So you just created a custom song. This is called Forever. Yes, Christ. All right, now I said that the BPM, I think it's because it's a minute and 3 seconds long, it's gonna be about like 120 or 115. So let me see what it is. I'll just look it up, the BPM, it's 120. 120 at B major. Okay. So I will take what that is said, put there, and I'm not even going to mess with anything else. I'm literally just going to do the drums. So right now I'm going to post it as the drums. And then from there, I'm going to test it in the game. So, and then once we have that drums in there, I'm going to save as, going to put that to wherever. Now what I will do is I'll open another folder. I'll drag it to this other monitor, which you will not see. Scroll up to the custom songs, which has all my songs and all the other people's songs, and find that Forever sig and pack file, which I mean I could show it to you right here. I'm just gonna have to move it back. I made it there, so the mod will bring out a sig and pack file. These two will be thrown into Fuser, and right now it should be into the Fuser game. So From here, I'm gonna go check it out, see how this goes, and then I'll stream it. I'll stream the game, but it's not done yet. This modded thing is not done. I have to keep testing and testing and testing to where it will sound just as it would. So it's not done yet, but once I get there, I should be able to finally make a full stream out of it. But man, it's good stuff. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to find the stream itself on here. Hopefully we'll be able to get it down. It is in B major, so that's what I'm gonna take. Oh my God, what am I doing? I can't go into a freestyle yet. All the modded songs are in here. I just gotta find the song itself, which is called God Forever. It's right there. So like I said, I only got the drum portion in there, and we'll see how this goes. So what I'm doing right now is I'm literally just testing out any other drum that's in the game. If they're together and they sound great together, then we are good. And usually how I test it is I'll go straight to 90 BPM. And then see if they hit, even at the slowest beat. Which is sounding really promising right now for the first try. Wow. That is amazing. I didn't know I'd get it in one shot. Okay, cool. So with that, I will close Fuser down right now, and I will get everything else. So like I said, I got all the drum portions in. All I gotta do now is get the lyrics and get the instrumentals. So what I'm gonna do next now is the synth. So this is the synth portion. Forever. I usually call it yellow because my yellow desk. Okay, and then throw this down. Boom, boom. Bam, boom, boom, bam. But you will see it right here. This is the bass portion right here. Oh, fuck. All right, so we got the bass portion done. And now we do the a cappella part, which is the lyrics. Now I have all parts. Now that all parts are in, I'm going to open up my mod. Like I said, the drums worked perfectly, so I'm just going straight to the other ones. Ever bass, synth, which is great. Put that in there, synth, yellow, and then vocal. All right. So since we have all that in, the next part is like a little bit more, like just a little part here. I'm trying to do natural pitching so that the person singing, even when you change keys, they will sound as they would try to sound like as if they would change keys. If you never did, like if you didn't do this, what would happen when you would change keys? Like at perfect key, since this is in B major, if at perfect B major, it sounds just like Chris Brown. But if you switch over to F or something, he's gonna sound like a super high pitch or super low pitch, and it just does not sound good at all. So what I would have to do is I would export that Fusion file. We'll go over here, change to maintain format, change it to one on both. There's two of them that you're supposed to do. So that was the first one. Here's the second one. Save that. I'm just speed running through this whole thing. Grab the thing that I just saved and then save the whole thing. And then throw it into the game. And we should be good. Once it pops up. Where is it? I think it's in my pictures. Okay. Replace the files and boom. Now, I think we just now put in a new song into the game. So, here we go. This is gonna be fun. And I think from here on out, if everything sounds perfect, I'm going to start the actual stream, not the modding part. I can actually get into the real streaming part. If everything works, I'm going to create a separate stream and make that as the real stream. This one here, everything that I've been doing in this has just been modding. So let's see. And this is my first test, so. Okay, here we go. Now, I'm like, to me, I'm still not done. What I have to do next is try to mess with the audio, make sure the volume is correct. So far, it's really good. I'm just gonna bring in the normal drum, so. I'm bringing this. I love this yellow, so I want to hear this go. Oh yeah! Let's try something else. Let's try something else. I hear you. I hear you. Wait, whoa, what was that? Okay. No, I just realized something was still playing in that drum section. So give me 1 second to load up the drum section because that was wrong. What the fuck was that? Yeah, no, that's what it was. You're supposed to mute that. That's supposed to be there. What the fuck? Okay. That's fine. It's going to be easy fix. We just move the drums. Going over to the replace audio. Make sure this audio is the drum section. And we should have the forever drums. Now complete. Save as. I'm going to put it in the pictures folder. Just so I can eat it. So it's an easy grab. But yeah. That is modding Fuser. Right there. Okay. So we're going to try one more time. We're going to play the whole way just to make sure it sounds good. If it does sound good, it sounds great. Then we're going to make an actual stream and just end this modding stream. Because this stream here was just strictly just for showing how I do the mods. And also at the same time, I wanted to put a song in and I didn't want to not stream too late. So I'll just start a stream with me testing a mod out or testing how I would put this specific song into the game. So let's see. Okay, so I just put it in. I just fixed that drum. Hopefully now I'm putting it in with the crate of all major songs. Hopefully. This song might work. So what was really cool is that the audio is already good. I didn't have to, what I thought about making it 200% is already good enough. And then the pitching should be good, so if I switch it to F, he won't sound super high pitch or low pitch. Sounds decent, so I'll take it. Wait. Okay. So there was a little cut. What I'm gonna do with this synth portion, like that note right there, I'm gonna take this note, put that in there, add that part as a synth along with the other synths that's playing so that it will transition perfectly. This is the part where this is super this part now, like what I'm doing is literally just being nitpicky. Like I really want this perfect now. Since that I got everything else, we're gonna make sure that everything that I put in here is gonna be perfect so that when it transitions, it's seamless. And that's what most people want when they do the game. And that's how I kind of want it when I do my mods. So let's go grab this in there, throw it in there, and then we should be good. Now that it's loading, load up Fuser again, and then we'll try one more time. And then after that, I will like, and then after that, I'll make an actual stream, which I'll just, you know, just start and end, like, end and start a new stream. Just put a different title or some shit. But this is this right here. This took about, how long have I been streaming? It took me an hour. Well, not really an hour. I was talking for a good amount of time. So if I was actually doing it and I was quiet and I wasn't explaining anything, it's probably might have taken me about 40 minutes. So, all right, let's see it. And then also I will add this song to my Google Drive so that you guys can download it. You guys keep it. Let's see this. That is nice. That's nice. Okay. All right, we did it. We're good. This is it. All right, now I'm gonna actually make a real stream out of this. So I will be leaving and coming right back within seconds. I like within 10 seconds. Give me a second.